And today's class is about the investors' protection. All are investors. In case of marketing term, we used to call it as all are customers. In marketing, we are having Customers Protection Act. Same thing, here we are having the Investors Protection Act. There are a number of Investor Protection Act. So in case of capital market, we are going to discuss about the what is the role taken by SEBI, even RBI and the exchanges to protect the investors. That's what today class we are going to discuss. I have posted three newses, of course. But since you are all traveling, some of you, the response is very poor. I noticed that one, I think, till now, nobody responded. Everybody is thinking about how to take decision making. That I know. Maybe that reason they are all busy. Once again, I am reminding, all the WhatsApp posts will have the activity. If you are not posting anything after that, don't ask me about the marks for activity. Here is the first podcast news. You can see about one of the interesting news from the Financial Industry Regulatory Authority, FINRA. Of course, this organization is registered in US. It is a private organization. And this organization is now taking the responsibility of protecting the global investors, not only Indian investors. And it has been recognized by the New York Exchange and NASDAQ also. And these people are now giving instructions to the investors how you can protect, especially because of the online frauds. Number of online frauds are going on. So in such case, how you can protect yourself? And another thing, there are a number of manipulations are going on. And next class also, we are going to discuss about the some of the big frauds, how they are using the insider trading, how they used to speculate. So in such a case, how we can protect our investors? Here is the FINRA news. This news clearly says that FINRA is now taking the risk of regulating the overseas brokers also. In case of disputes, some brokers may not be available when you are entering into the contract or when you are coming out of the contract. Some of them may be available when you are entering into the contract. Suddenly they may disappear. What is the position of the investor? These are all the unethical practices in capital markets. To reduce these type of unethical practices, this private agency has been established by the US under the name Financial Industry Regulatory Authority. See that one, they are providing what are all the actions and reactions you have to take when you are investing. Once you invested, what are your rights and duties? They are taking that responsibility and they are maintaining a nice database. I think some of you know it is called Broker Check Database. That database is maintained by the FINRA. Through that, they are monitoring what are all the problems faced by the investors. If suddenly one broker is not available, some of the securities may be with them, some of the contract notes may be with them, how to protect that one? Likewise, movement of share price, somebody may create an artificial demand. Somebody may create artificial supply. Because capital market is called as a regulatory, speculative body. one of the English authors clearly mentioned that capital market means only in speculation. Since speculation are going on, there is need for nice regulatory authority to protect the investors. Here is one example of that one, FINRA. In case of India also, SEBI, that is Security Exchange Board of India, it is taking the regulatory role of controlling the investors in BSE, NSE, and India NX. See that one. Even just 3 days back, SEBI has taken a nice method whether we can introduce the swing pricing to protect the investors, to avoid from the overpricing or underpricing. Say, for example, Farzin may enter into buy a security. Farzin decided to buy today Tata Motors. Broker is saying, I will buy you, but one share cost rupees 2,500. If you are ready to pay me 2,500 rupees per share, that is per security, I will give you Tata Motors shares. What is the role of Farzin there? See that one. Dear students, this type of speculation is created by the brokers. It is the unethical one. Even then, the investors are moving towards such type of brokers. Still, I remember 1 year back, one of the stock brokers announced that if you give us 10% premium when you are buying a share or security, we will take the responsibility of selling that one if the price are increasing and give you a return in addition to the price fluctuation. We are ready to provide 20% profit. There was one shocking news. Of course, it was in WhatsApp media. Finally, the SEBI has taken the restrictions. It is an unethical practice. The prices are openly disclosed by the Bombay Stock Exchange, NSE, India NX, through all the media persons. Whether you are seeing CNBC TV18, NDTV, or Economic Times, or Bloomberg, you are clearly seeing what is the price now. They made it as transparent. Even then, the investors are approaching the brokers and they are ready to pay high. They will see the CNBC TV18 channel or NDTV profit channel or Bloomberg or Economic Times and mention that Tata Motors price is just 1,900 rupees. It is going on like that. Let us assume. So they may enter into a contract for buying only for 1,900. Of course, there may be plus or minus by 5%. But you know, some of the investors are ready to buy even for 2,500. The prices in TV, they are disclosing 1,900. And some brokers are telling like that. And to avoid all those things, and to protect the investors. Of course, speculation itself is considered as the gray market by the English literature authors. But the SEBI has taken the regulations. All the capital market authorities are taking the steps to control that one. In this one recently, the SEBI says that why can't we can go for swing pricing? Swing pricing is not for securities in the form of debt or equity. It is for the mutual funds industry. In case of mutual funds, I think some of you know, they will sell in terms of net asset value. The price per unit is mentioned in terms of net asset value because they are investing in different organizations. They are selling only the units. if they are getting 10,000 rupees from you, a mutual fund organization will invest 10,000 in different securities. They are taking the role of investing your money. This 10,000 rupees is called an unit. And for that unit, instead of share price, they use it called as net asset value. Net asset value means simply what is the market price of the investment assets by that time. If you are buying today, what is the market value of the investments as on today? That is the net asset value. So you will buy based upon the net asset value. So what is happening? When Neeraj is placing the orders with buy one of the brokers of the unit holders, they will mention that the unit price is today 18,000 rupees. Okay, Neeraj assumed that one, he may enter into a contract. But suddenly, when Neeraj is in online and ready to file in online contract, they may say that, sorry, sir, the price has been increased by another 2,000. So now it becomes 20,000. But Neeraj is seeing in right hand side, the NDTV, all those things, and he's mentioning it is not moving in a very good direction. But you are saying that more than 10% increased. That is why the brokers are dominating. To avoid that one, the BSE along with the SEBI created a concept swing pricing. That is the maximum and minimum amount. We have to wait and see what type of swing pricing they are aiming. But simply speaking, the maximum price and the minimum price. If the price is going on 18,000 per unit, the SEBI will fix. You can sell or buy maximum to 18,100. That's all. The swing price. And minimum, you can sell for 17,900. So, plus or minus 100 rupees. That is the swing price. One end and the another end. If you are playing in the swing, you must know. It will go to the one end up, then suddenly comes down, then it goes up. Same manner. They wish to fix the both corner price. What is the maximum end price we can fix? And what is the minimum end price we can fix? That is the swing pricing. And now SEBI is thinking about that one to protect the pricing. That is quite common. So dear students, that is why the recent measures clearly mention that to protect the mutual funds holders, that is, they are decided to have the net asset value method coming under the swing pricing. That's what SEBI is proposing. So in future, if you are going and sitting and working in EY or KPMG, you may work to find out what will be the swing price today. That is why we are discussing today itself. Dear students, this is the, some of the measures SEBI introduced recently. So based upon that news, you must know clearly what are all the measures the SEBI is taking at present. We are continuing the same thing with the conceptual one. You can see the measures taken by SEBI. What are all the acts coming under the protecting the investors? As usual, the Companies Act 2013, the new Companies Act, previously it was 1956, now 2013. Act. Then in case of SEBI, that is one guideline. Listing obligation and disclosure requirements. We used to call it a SEBI regulation 2015. It is also considering the protecting the investors. Then SEBI, prohibition of insider trading regulations. We are going to study separately the insider trading. So, as per this acts, we can say, Companies Act, SEBI Act for Disclosure 2015, SEBI Act relating to insider trading 2015, it is mandated to disclose some of the facts, not only the profit, but also other facts into the website. Okay. However, the previous chairman, when the Sinha was chairing the SEBI, he created a new rule for the insider trading. Of course, we are going to discuss in the next class about the insider trading. Insider trading, simple thing, somebody will manipulate. Say, for example, if Neeraj is ready to buy at least 10 lakh shares. So Neeraj is a very good investor. In other hand, Ritwij is also a good investor. He is already ready to buy another 10 lakhs rupees of securities. Both of them are approaching a person. So immediately that broker knows that, there's a huge demand by these two persons. They are having very nice friends in social media. So if these two guys buy, a minimum another 10 persons will buy. So what these people will do? They try to manipulate the prices. They used to create an artificial demand. We used to call it as bullwhip effect also. An artificial demand has been created. Based upon that, one of the company managers or who is responsible for that organization may increase or decrease the price. That is the insider trading. Likewise, the organization itself, say for example, if Neeraj is running Neeraj Private Limited, he knows the profit of his own company. And as per the guidelines, Neeraj has to disclose the profits only after the audit. So now Neeraj company audit has been over. So, and the auditors know that the profit is around 200 crores. So the auditor should maintain silence. If the auditor informs somebody else, and Neeraj's friend, if he discloses to the public that Neeraj Limited is running 200 crores profit, based upon that event, Neeraj company may attract more investments in share market. It is also illegal, be clear. It is also one type of insider trading. Even though there is no fault on the Neeraj, some insider, some of his friend or some of the managing director of the Neeraj Limited might have announced to the public that our company is going to earn 200 crores or our company earned 200 crores. There is a formality there. When to disclose the profit once it has been audited and they have to send the report to the SEBI. Then in the meeting, maybe in AGM, they will disclose that our company, that is Neeraj, will announce that, dear shareholders, I am also among you. Your company earned 200 crores. He has to announce that one in the annual general meeting. From that day, immediately there may be good demand for Neeraj Limited shares. But before the announcement of the Neeraj in the annual general meeting, some of his directors, maybe the Black Fox, what this Black Fox will do? he knows. Before announcement in the annual general meeting, these black box will call the newspaper or send the information to the news agencies as well as to the media that Neeraj company already gained 200 crores. It is also considered as an insider trading. The aim is to increase the price in stock exchange. This black box is telling that the price has been increased. That is the reason. Yeah, when the previous chairman Sinha was there, he introduced different laws to stop the insider trading. And also he introduced the price manipulation system where the prices are going, how the prices are fixed, whether it is purely based upon the demand and supply. The new rules has been created from the SEBI, and you can see that one, they introduce the disgorgement process also. Disgorgement process means if anybody done a mistake here, they can recover that one. It may be gain or it may be loss. It was introduced by the SEBI to protect that one. If any manipulation happens, the SEBI will come into the power and it may take that one. And SEBI also given the number of guidelines. It relaxes the preferential allotment norms for the promoters. Due to this COVID, some relaxation has been given to the companies. Like that, it given the some permission to voluntary open offer norms. Some restrictions have been relaxed, but not taken over. The reason is during this COVID time, the prices are stagnating. That is why to have a move for an upward trend, this will be introduced the relaxation norms. So that is also possible. But if it is coming under relaxation, then it is not considered as an offense. Okay. Another move taken by the SEBI, proliferation of investment counselors. It creates a number of investment counselors, and before investing, even after investing, you can have the investment advisors, and most of these investment advisors, they are also cheating. That is why some unethical practices are going on. That is why the FINRA is regulating that one. If you are investing in global level, to identify the lack of transparency or to identify the short selling process, SEBI has given the new guidelines. You must know the short selling. That is, the shares may be borrowed at very less price, but so selling in the market for current market price. That is happening. It is as usual. The brokers, what they will do, if our Sam decided to sell his shares, from Sam they will buy for less price, but they will sell in the market for the current price. That is called the short selling. It is quite common by the most of the brokers, but now the SEBI is clearly giving guidelines that if SEBI identified any short selling, the broker's license will be moved out. Of course, if it is not short selling, but it is an ethical one as per the practice, it is allowed. You can see that one. Now the investors complaint cell has been introduced in BSE, NSE and SEBI also. In addition to that, Department of Financial Services is also having public grievance cell. It is in the form of different one. You can see in case of BSE, its name is DIS, Department of investor services. So they are providing the investor services from Bombay Stock Exchange. In case of NSE, we are having investors services cell. But even then, some of the brokers are dominating there. SEBI is having scores. That is SEBI compliance redressal system. Even our Reserve Bank of India, since it is controlling the monetary authority, they also included the ombudsman concept in investment. Then the Ministry of Finance under the Departments of Financial Services recently included the public grievances redressal mechanism. These are all the some of the services provided by these type of marketers to protect their investors. Okay? And you can see even SEBI is having the power to inspect the stock exchanges. Of course, in those days, there was a platform in BSE and they used to shout and sell from that. You might have seen in the same Guru film. Even now, if you visit the BSE, you can see that floor in the BSE. A very big hall. Now it is not happening. Of course, you can see inside that building, there was a very big room. And in that big room only, they used to buy and sell shirts. The brokers will raise the hand. I am having these shirts. Come on. These shirts are ready to sell. We are ready to buy. They used to raise, shout. All these things will going on in that room. Same thing what you have seen in the Guru film, how the Abhishek Bachchan used to enter into the market. Even now in grey market nearby Dalal Street, you can see that one. In grey market, it is still very famous. I think in some of the places near one of the places in Mumbai, Colaba, yes. There also there are some small grey market area. It is equal to a big Kalyan Mandapam, a big marriage hall. In that one, the grey market is happening nicely. I don't know how this grey market price is determined. Previously, BSE was also like that. They used to go for auction sales, bidding sales inside a room. Now, everything is legalized and bring into an online platform. You can buy and sell only in online. That is how BSE created a nice method now. So in case of BSE, you might have seen, now it is online trading, no offline trading. That is why the SEBI is having the power to visit the stock exchange. All are in same place. SEBI, NSE, BSE, all are in Mumbai. Anytime the SEBI authorities can go to BSE and they can inspect whether everything is going on as per the norms. Of course, now it is in online, so they can watch everything in online. That is why in case of NSE, they created an investor education and protection fund. See that one, to protect the investors in the budget speech during the 2006 and 7, the government introduced that one. So it was introduced with the $2 million, around 10 crores. Now, the investor education is done by the SEBI. You know, there are some of the trainers that usually in case of undergraduate program, I think some of you know from NASM, there are a number of persons that they use to train. If you are investing in securities, what are all the points you have to see? What are all the terms used in the stock exchange? They are there for the purpose of training also. Another one, unethical practices. As already told, it is the disgorgement. Disgorgement, it is the process of recovering the gains from wrongdoers. If anybody is going against the SEBI rules, these brokers' money will be confiscated and given to the investors. That is why now the depository system has been clearly changed and incorporated the entire process of buying and selling. You can see that one, first the listed company. Once from a listed company, somebody can buy, it will be registered and the DMAT securities will be given within the 15 days. Then it goes to one copy to the repositories also. Depositories are there. It will go there. Your DMAT securities will be only in a NSDL method under depositories. Okay. So based upon the information from the depositories only, the stock exchange give information to the website. So that is the process they created. How they are protecting that one, whether the investors are investing in listed shares, that is very important thing. They are creating the awareness. Don't invest in which, if the securities are not listed. Be clear. Only in case of listed shares, the BSE and the NSE will come forward to help you. That is why they have mentioned clearly, provide information about the promoter and the promoter group. And you can register and share the transfer agent. The authentication will be done. Anyway, if you are trading only after 15 days, they will give the proper authentication. Now it comes with the 2 days. Okay. So what is the role of SEBI here? You can see that one, the SEBI Act of 1992. It defined the fraudulent practices. It mentioned that different names, fraudulent trade practice or unfair trade practice or manipulative trade practices. That is also very important thing. You should not manipulate. Everything should be based upon the demand and supply. Be clear. That is why it is mentioned that fraudulent trade practice or unfair trade practices or manipulative trade practices have not been defined. Okay. So these are some of the major reforms taken by the organization. So what is the role of Security Exchange Board of India? Whether to protect investors or to create a capital flow, both are done by the SEBI. You can see the organization of the Security Exchange Board of India. Here on the other day, same who is chairing now. In case of SEBI, there are a number of departments, primary market, issue management, secondary market, and institutional investors. These centers or departments in SEBI will take care of these type of online frauds. Okay? And in each department, they are having their own advisory committees. Okay? That is why in conceptual method, if you want to discuss the powers and functions of SEBI, you can see that one. SEBI is having the right to regulate. That is as usual. Everybody know. Then, even SEBI is having the power to regulate the working hours of the stock exchange. Then, SEBI only mentioned clearly that who are eligible to register. Be clear. Like as they mentioned, promoting, regulating, self-regulatory organization. That is important thing. Whether the broker or any other organization coming under the financial services, they are calling it self-regulatory organizations. then you can see that one, prohibiting fraudulent and unfair trade practices relating to securities, all these things are there. So if anything goes wrong, according to the SEBI, they can use its power. You can see that one, what are all the things SEBI can regulate, in which areas SEBI can give importance, regulation of the activities, especially buying and selling activity, protecting the rights of investors. First, once the transaction is happening, whether the person who purchased informed others, then to prevent malpractice and fraudulent activities. Some of them, they are nicely creating the malpractices in online. Then to develop code of conduct for the intermediaries, such as brokers, mutual funds, sellers, etc. That is, SEBI is having the right to fix the code of conduct. That's what we seen as a new student just 40 minutes back. We have discussed some of the news. It is, these are all the good examples of the measures taken by the SEBI. You can see that one, the present chairman mentioned that even SEBI is ready to provide services under the risk management. Be clear. That is why the SEBI chairman clearly mentioned that now we are able to track the funds flow, everything of the organization. So if any organization given a wrong information, immediately it will be delisted from the exchange board. You can see how the practices are happening. If the Nifty broker, that is circuit breakers, are triggered, what will happen? That's a nice example. You can see that one, first Nifty is failing by 10%. Even though there is no halt in the trading. Trading is halted for 60 minutes since the prices are moving down. You can see that one, based upon the price only. Finally, at the end, the Nifty falls another 5%. So what it shows, they will create a nice method to inform to the public this company is having, these are the plus points and these are the minus point. That is why SEBI also introduced the investors education. That is SEBI versus SEBI, different regulations, stock exchange and depositories, how to regulate the regional players, the investor association, trade bodies. They created all this statutory organization which will work under the SEBI, not independently. These are the organization to work under the SEBI. You can see that one, the SEBI conducted number of investigations so far. Some major investigations are here in December 2018. You can see SEBI has taken the standardizing the records. Then in 2019, that is, it mentions the directs the brokers to report day-wise stock, that is physical presence by the HR people. Marketing and April starts matching exchange brokers along with the repository. Whether the name mentioned in the record is tallying with the demat account. Or Neeraj might have purchased from a broker. Broker sent the clear cut certificates. But in case of SEBI, one issue, they investigated this thing also. Whether it is matching with the depositories. Then in April, SEBI starts tallying details of pledged shares. number of measures they have taken. In June, stops brokers from raising fund by pledging client share. Very important thing. You should not pledge the customer's asset for raising the fund. Okay, likewise, in August 31st, they have taken another nice decision. In September 30th, some of the organization brokers failed to report to full segregation case. The report has been underway, but this even deregulated some of the companies. Here is a snapshot of what happened in Karvi stock broking. However, some cheating between the transfer of shares among the Karvi versus others. Here you can see the settlement system that is also noticed by the SEBI under the No Stars protection. You can see that one, whether any brokers or all the brokers are clearly following the settlement cycle system. Be clear, because most of the frauds are happening here. When they are settling, they used to tell that, sir, today's price increased or today's price decreased. That is why SEBI issued the guidelines on the checking of this type of trading mechanism. And as we know, SEBI banned the insiders trading. Another interesting news. So these are all the some of the measures taken by the SEBI. So in addition to that, SEBI is introducing number of things, investors protection, everything. But most of the things, SEBI is clearly defined in the act. Even then, some what we call the small scams are going on. Now SEBI is monitoring and it is clearly mentioning that it is also planning to move towards the blockchain technology. If the blockchain technology comes, now the SEBI is ready to control the investors' value and investors' right in the right direction. That is the method. Likewise, in case of the RBI, even Ministry of Finance is also taking stringent measures. Even then, some of the scams are coming. I think you might have seen some of the brokers, they are entering into the scam. They are buying in 1992. That is from 1991 to 1992. We witnessed a very big scam. I think some of you know. Anybody know what is the name of the scam? Who? In 1991 to 92. I think you might have studied in UG level or in school level about that big scam. Only because of that, even SEBI came into existence. Anybody knows what is that scam? The biggest scam in the BSE, in capital markets in India. That is the reason why SEBI came into power and SEBI created that one. What is the name of the scam? Come on. What? Wow. Joel Pal?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Joel, come on. Do you know biggest scam held in BSE?
Not this one, but other scams are there that I'm pretty aware.
Yes. Tell me this name of the scam.
It's a Dabba scam.
Dabba scam, okay. Any other one? Anybody knows that one? Good. What happened? I think you started sleeping and you are also making me a nice sleep then. Harshad Mehta scam.
Yes, Harshad Mehta, PMC.
Yes, good. I think there is one film released based upon the Arshad Mehta scam. Do you remember that name of the film, anybody?
The scam 1992.
Yes, good. And if you see that film, they nicely demonstrated how the scam happened. But it is an unethical one, but most of the scam authorities are saying that they wish to create an unethical practice into an ethical one with their mindset. That is quite common. Even in those days, it was happening. Yes, come on.
So in the scam of 1992, it was moreover, so there were no regulation at that time between the banks for the transactions. Like if a company is taking a loan on the behalf, they don't have the regulations at that time that showed that a particular BR has been allotted to someone.
Yes, that is so the deposit receipt. Good.
Yes, sir.
Banker's receipt. In those days, if you want to buy, you can send the amount to the bank and bankers will create a deposit receipt or banker's receipt. It means that you already purchased. Then at the time of allotment, your shares will come in those days. But nowadays, it is not like that. Everything will be settled in online immediately. So what the Arshad Mehta did, he issued some bogus deposit receipts from the one of the famous banks. Bank doesn't know. But in the name of the DR, that is deposit receipts, he issued the Arshad Mehta. Most of them purchased the shares from Arshad Mehta. They thought that they are having n number of shares with Arshad Mehta and it is with the BSE. Say, for example, our Ritika purchased from Arshad Mehta. She assumed that, okay, I'm having around 5,000 shares of Tata Motors. She might have thought like that. But what happened? Some of the persons ready to sell the shares, they know that there was no shares in their name. But they are having the deposit receipt. They have been issued the deposit receipt. And Arshad Mehta manipulated a number of things. In those days, there was no act like SEBI. In those days, they were having the Controller of Capital Issues Act. Since the scam was very big, we need a regulator. That is why SEBI came into existence. Security Exchange Board of 1992. Otherwise, we won't witness the such type of things. There are a number of scams are happening. Only thing, investors should be very, very clear about their brokers. If you are not clear with the brokers, then you will lose the money. Even I think I noticed in one film in Amazon Prime 2 weeks back. There also, they used to portray nicely how far the scam is happening, how far the villain is taking over the security deposits in Federal Reserve. Federal Reserve means like Indian government in US, it is the Federal Reserve. How he is manipulating the Federal Reserve and how he is creating the bogus notes, the villain used to create nicely. So, dear students, most of the brokers are good, but it is our duty to find out whether our transactions are ethical and whether it is going in a proper direction. Otherwise, we have to face the problem as an investor. That is why, like in marketing, let the buyer beware. Covet emptor system. It is working well in capital market also. We can't argue. Number of cheat funds are there. They are simply cheating the public. Same thing. The scam is also like that. Some of them, brokers, in buying and selling, they are creating some scam. Some of them go to the advanced level, creating the insider trading and manipulate the prices. It is like the black market. I already told the story how in black market they are doing. Even the black market in some cases legalized. In case of Singapore, it is legalized. Still, I remember, I think our Sagar is here. Sagar, are you there? I remember that one of the film acted by that Rajinikanth, when I was in India, in those days I paid around 100 rupees. Remember that in those days, the cinema charges are just 5 rupees. And you know, the fans of Rajinikanth used to create a speculation one. If maximum is the 5 rupees ticket when you are going for cinema and seeing that one. But on the day of release, first 1 week, who will speculate? The Rajinikanth fans. They are having some of the associations. And these associations used to speculate by selling the cinema tickets in the grey market. That is also the scam. But it was allowed in those days. Sometimes if police are coming, they may escape, they may run out. Same thing. After 15 years of seeing the Rajinikanth film, another 15 years later, I think some of you know, there is one film acted by Rajinikanth in the name of Baba. It was released when I was in Singapore. You know, when I went to the film to saw in Singapore, the price has been fixed by that time, $25. Not by the Rajinikanth fans. It is legalized and mentioned in the theaters itself. There also, Singapore also, they used to release the films. Usually in case of Singapore, it comes around $2 or $3. But if you want to see the first show on the first day, they made it legal as $25. See that one, $25 is a very big amount. By that time, Indian currency versus Singapore currency exchange itself is around 40 rupees. But in Singapore, it is legalized. How they legalized? They clearly mentioned that during first 15 days of any release of any film, you can go up to the maximum price. That is what we call it as swing pricing system. They fixed. But in case of India, it was illegal. Only the black market people, they used to fix. Even in case of Bangalore, I still remember in Majestic Theatre. In those days, when the films of Rajkumar is releasing, by that time, they used to double or triple the prices. It was considered as speculation. Same thing. Dear students, this is how the people are cheated. That is why here is another interesting news. Why RBI and SEBI is silent on illegal digital DABA trading? Now another thing is going on in form of digital DABA trading, not DABA trading. DABA trading is equal to black market. If most of them are ready to invest, suddenly the government announced that everybody will get 15 lakh rupees. Or for the central government employees, they may say that we are increasing DA with effect from 2020. So almost all the central government employees will receive an arrears for around 5 lakhs, 6 lakhs rupees. By that time, what these brokers will do, they wish to grab that money to invest. And they decided to go for DABA trading. You can invest with us. We will give good return. Now it is going in a digital method. See that one. That is why one of the person asked, why RBI and SEBI is silent? Of course, we are going to face the regulatory authority body. Now they are thinking about why can't we can introduce the blockchain here. Only solution to reduce this type of digital DABA trading is the blockchain. So in future, dear students, you have to enter into blockchain technology. That is why I try to study some basic things in blockchain technology. Then only when these type of new market measures are coming, you are able to identify. It is not illegal. Like ethical hacking tools, you must know that what are all the tools available to protect the investors and make the share trading system ethical? That is the purpose of today's core discussion. Even though for the examination point of view, what are all the measures taken by SEBI for protecting the investors? But as an MBA student, you must know how we can make a perfect market in capital markets, especially dealing ethical manner. Or if some unethical practices are happening, how to catch that thing and make them into a stream manner. We used to call it as sandboxing. There is one English term used in stock market for that purpose. Sandboxing the scams. That is the purpose why you MBA students are studying. Already you might have studied this, what are the measures taken by SEBI for protecting investors. That is in undergraduate level. When you are for the MBA level, you must know how the scams will happen, how to protect, how to overthrow that one. That you must know. That is the purpose why you are studying. That is why I discussed how the scam is coming, how to identify the checkmates. I think you are studying, might have studied in ethics, big scams. To avoid that one, we need a new method of protection. So with this, we'll conclude the class. So dear students, I hope you, when you are coming to the application level, when you are ready to come for the capital market, you are all be ethical traders. And if you are an investor, you know your rights so that you will know how to invest, where to invest, and how to gain profit in an ethical manner. With this, we will conclude today's class. I think still some of you are not opening your video. Switch on your camera.